as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Hi everyone, it's my amazing Zoo, and today I'll be doing a welcome video for Braylon, Evie, and Maddie. So, sorry about my shadow, the light is kind of coming from behind me, and sorry about the poops. I spot cleaned this morning, but you little ladies are just so crazy. So, this is Madeline. She is a year old, and she doesn't have red eyes, it's just like the lighting, as you can see, she has black eyes. And Braylon is the one behind her, and she is also a year old. They are sisters, and they are Silky. Oh, hi Mia. Mia's behind me. We are in the pet room, but I really wanted to wait for this video to show, like, show the new cage. We will be replicating Carrie's little piggy's cage. We have made modifications to fit our needs, but anyways, this is not the point of the video, and that's why I really wanted to wait, but I know I needed to get this up, so yeah. So that video should be up in 3 weeks. Yeah, it's gonna take a while. Anyway, so we'll start with Maddie since Braylon decided to go in the house and come back out. So we got them in Cleveland. It was about a 4-hour drive, but we were already going there for a wedding, and the drive went very smoothly. We took a store-bought guinea pig cage, which is not suitable for regular housing, but for a travel is wonderful. I think, you guys have a little tip right there. Yeah. it's very suitable, so that was interesting. They mostly stayed in their houses, which is to be expected, but we're still going through the taming process, and Maddie's definitely the more outgoing one, and Braylon's the more more skittish one. But sometimes they do have tips, and yeah, so she is a tricolor, Maddie is. She has brown in the front, gray, and then white. I call her my ombre piggy because she goes from dark to light. And then Braylon is a brownish black on the back part of her, and then her front is brown with a little speckle of white under her chin, which I think is just adorable. Oops, sorry, that's my finger. That was so bad. And here's the water bottle. I'm not doing very good filming today. I'm trying to see if you can see her speckled chin. Anyways, sorry about my stuffy nose. I'm just having a bad filming day today. Oh, and so they do live next to Evie. Sorry for the pumpkin house that is tipped over. I recreated Valerie's zoo DIY pumpkin house, and she seemed to have tipped it over. Anyways, now they are hiding. They are so adorable, and I love them so much. So they are girls, both sisters. And so here's their story. So these people that we got them from, we got them off Craigslist, and it was a teacher, and she had three children, one son and a daughter, and the daughter wanted guinea pigs. And so they found a silky breeder 8 minutes away from their home, which is so lucky. Oh, you can see Evie's little nose. Which is so lucky because I can never find anything. Let's see if we can catch Evie. They're so lucky because I can never find anything near me. And so I guess she showed her guinea pigs, which I don't really support because I think it's just a stressful life for them, but you can do what you please. And so they were not, I guess, show quality. So she showed the one, she sold the ones that weren't, I guess, up to her standards. And I'm really sorry about the poops, those are bothering me. But yeah, she sold them for $20, and that's how they got these two. And so they had them for about a year, but then their children decided that they weren't into them anymore, which happens with a lot of guinea pig owners. So I'm glad they couldn't take